Hello everyone, this is Ken Ebreni from Cambridge Tech, and welcome back to the part 2 of WeLearning Bootstrap. So in the first video, we looked at the introductory aspect of Bootstrap, and we also had a preview of the final project that we are going to build after learning some of the rudiments of Bootstrap. Now in this particular video, we are going to look at contextual colors. Remember, we need not to come in here and come and write in a lot of colors. Like if you want, for instance, color blue, you need to come and specify it over. All that we need to do is to specify a color like we have it over here. But this txt dash primary is only one of many colors that we have. So now let's start with the contextual colors. And in order to do that, let me just put out a comment over here. And I'll call this contextual colors. All right, so let me change this to Learn Bootstrap. So once over here, we have Learn Bootstrap showing up. Good. Now let me duplicate this a number of times. So I'll do a Shift Alt and a down arrow key. So the number of colors, and as you can see, primary is kind of the bluish color. So now if your guess is as good as mine, maybe we can have secondary, and actually we have secondary. But bear in mind, it is not just secondary, it is txt-secondary. What txt-secondary does is we want to change the color of the text to a secondary color. So when I save this, remember the rest is, let me clear them off for now. So I'll just maintain these two. So we have txt primary and txt secondary, and txt secondary is a little bit grayish in color. Remember, these are the default colors, and this is a little bit grayish. So that's the secondary. Now we have txt dash danger. Now let's go and see the danger. The danger is a redish color. Then we have, so I think for now, let me just put it side by side so that we can see exactly what's going on. So let me come back here and let's see the other colors. So I can do a txt dash info, and when I save this, you can see that this is now the info color. I can also do a txt dash warning, and when I do warning is a yellow color. I can do a txt dash dark, but clearly the default colors over here are black, so the dark will not take any effect yet. But just by way of information to show you that there's a contextual dark color in here, we can do a txt dash muted, and the muted, it's almost like the secondary in terms of how the color looks like. So we are not quite done yet. Let me duplicate this a number of times, and after muted, we can do txt dash light. Now there are two things we are going to see over here. We have the txt dash light and the txt dash white. Now basically this is txt dash light and txt dash white, and clearly because the original background is white, we are not seeing them because this is light color and this is white color. So in order to see them, let me just jump ahead of it and show you exactly what we have. We also have another Bootstrap class that we can use, and that's a bg dash, let's say we can do bg dash info, and this is going to be the background color. So when I save this, now clearly we have the background info color, and now inside of it we can see that the txt dash light is showing up. Now what this also means is we can add a number of Bootstrap classes, as many as we want, on a particular HTML element, if and only if it makes sense. Okay, so this makes sense. The color, the txt dash light is going to target the text, and the bg dash info is going to target the background. It's just like writing the CSS and doing background, and we are specifying background, and we're also specifying color for the text. Good. So over here for the txt dash white, let's do a bg, and that's going to be the background. And we can do bg danger, and as you can see, the danger is going to be the reddish color, as you see over here. I almost forgot this one. We can also have a txt dash success, so success is going to be the greenish color over here. All right, so these are the main contextual colors. Now, with Bootstrap 5, and that's what we are learning, there have been some add-ons or some additions. And let me show you one of them here. So let's do still an H1. And let's see new additions. All right. So this is new additions. And for new additions, let's give it a BG, a background of danger. So when you do a background of danger, let me also change the color of the text. So I'll do a TXT and I'll say white. All right, so it doesn't really matter which comes first. Once the classes make sense to each other, it will work out. All right, so here we have the BG-danger and the TXT-white. Now with the newer versions of Bootstrap, as we are learning now, we can also apply an opacity to the colors. So let me also duplicate this one. So I'll do a shift alt and a down arrow key so that we have four of these showing up over here. All right, so in order to have some space, let me just put up a div tag over here and let me give a style and a height of let's say 500 pixels. Okay, so that you have this allowance showing up. So with the new classes, we can actually do, so let me come back to line 31, and on line 31, that's actually going to be the, like the second of the duplicates I have over here. We can do a TXT dash opacity. And when we do dash opacity, we need to specify like the level of opacity. So we can start with 25. So when I save this, you can see that there's obviously some change over here. Okay, obviously some change. Now let me also do a TXT dash opacity, and let's do 50 first. So when I save this, you can see now the TXT dash opacity is actually targeting the opacity of the text. Okay, so that's exactly what we are seeing over here, the opacity of the text. And we can do a TXT dash opacity, and over here we can do 75. So the opacity is going to be 75, and this is what we have. So this is an opacity of 25, an opacity of 50, and an opacity of 75. All right, so these are some of the new add-ons we have with Bootstrap. So let me come back here and let's see, learn Bootstrap. Okay, the first one we have over here, let's kind of add in some opacity classes over here. So these ones, and let's say we can do a TXT dash opacity, and let's do 25 for the first one. So as you can see, over here we can clearly see the difference. Then we can also have a TXT dash opacity, and let's do 50 over here. So here we have a different, or like the opacity has changed. And these are some of the new add-ons or the new additions with Bootstrap. We have the TXT dash opacity. All right, so as far as the opacity goes, we can also look at the opacity of the background color. Okay, remember all that we are doing is a TXT or the text opacity. So let me duplicate this a number of times, and let me just maintain the text. So I'll just come in here and get rid of this. So a Control D to get rid of this. So here we have these new ones showing up over here. And let me just do a BG. Let me come down here, Control D, a BG success. So I have this BG success over here. Now I can do a BG, so the background dash opacity, and this time around let me do 25. Okay, so when I do 25, you can see that the opacity has changed over here. It's a little bit whitish, or like there's some kind of transparency in here. And I can also do a BG opacity of, let me change this to 50. So this is about 50%, and Let me do a BG dash opacity, and let me do 75 over here. And here we are. So these are some of the new add-on as far as Bootstrap 5 is concerned. And as we move along, we are going to see some new add-on with some of the classes. So this brings us to the end of this video, and this is going to be the contextual colors. Now, if you find this tutorial very interesting, there are a couple of ways you can help me grow my channel. Kindly subscribe to Cambrotech, and don't forget to hit on the notification button so that anytime I release a video, you'll be duly notified. Also, share this video with friends and family who find this content very useful. At Cambrotech, we always say learn programming. You can do it. Thank you very much, and catch you in the next video. Bye-bye.